Pairing cranes is a complex process. All crane species form incredibly strong pair bonds with their mates and may not attempt to breed until they've been together for several years. At the International Crane Foundation, cranes are paired through a process called socialization. In captivity, a crane pair goes through a socialization process that's designed to help them create a lifelong pair bond, just as they would in the wild. In this video, you will learn about the techniques that ICF's aviculturists use to pair cranes.
It's important to have and breed cranes in captivity, especially here at the International Crane Foundation, because we know that the numbers of certain species of cranes in the wild are endangered or threatened. We just have sort of a genetic bank here, and we could use those birds and hopefully genetically match them up and help the numbers in the wild and maybe help bring back a population if we needed to. So cranes form really strong pair bonds, and it takes time for those pair bonds to be formed and to be strong enough that the birds will breed. Once that bond is formed, cranes tend to mate for life.
Determining what birds should be paired, there's a number of variables that play a role in that, and probably the largest deciding factor is the genetics of the bird. Because our focus with captivity is to increase the numbers in the wild while maintaining a healthy captive flock, we want to make sure that there's a lot of genetic diversity. The use of remote cameras has been very valuable for us because the bird's behavior is very different if there's a human in the area. Basically, they're aware of your presence and your presence is compromising their behaviors with each other. So once the two individuals have been identified, the first step of socialization is actually putting the birds in a divided pen with each other. We do put tennis netting up on the fence. Typically, the birds will be housed that way for several months, so they can hear each other and see each other, but they don't have the physical interaction. They kind of get to know each other. Oftentimes, one of the first steps will just be pulling back some of that tennis netting so they have an open chain link area where they can see each other. And if everything seems to be going well that way, then our next step would actually be to try and put the birds together. The first couple times the birds are put together are very short. They might just be 15, 20 minutes.
If those short periods of time where they're introduced to each other go really well, then we'll sort of start to move in different things, like we'll move in food and we'll move in water, and we'll generally increase the amount of time that the two birds are spending together in the same pen while we're watching them. And sort of as that continues on and the time gets longer and longer and the birds are more comfortable with each other, soon enough we will leave them together overnight. And then after their first night together, we'll tend to push that further and further, so they'll spend the whole day and the night together, and then they'll spend two nights together. And then at the end of that, the hope is that your birds are paired. Really, no two socializations are going to be the same. It depends on birds as individuals. They all sort of have their own personalities. We look at how the birds are on their own as an individual, and then how they are as a pair. The good things that we're looking for to know that our birds are paired are calling together. We'll also look for things like dancing, spending time close to one another, sharing the same food bucket, or sharing a water bucket. Just because a bird is together and looking really well, especially for the first breeding season, we will monitor those birds constantly. And that's simply because as we're socializing birds in the wintertime, their hormone levels are low. So even if we do get that pair socialized for the springtime, their hormone levels are going to increase in both birds. And that can cause all sorts of different things to happen.
So once a pair has been established, we typically give them two full breeding seasons to try and reproduce naturally. If after 2 years we're still getting infertile eggs, our next step would be to put the birds into an artificial insemination program.
If we can't socialize a pair for whatever reason it may be, and they're genetically valuable birds, we will do artificial insemination on them separately. And through artificial insemination, we are able to get that good genetic match and produce a chick from those two birds, even though they aren't physically together. ICF has been very successful in creating crane pairs. A lot of whooping crane pairs are here now, were socialized many years ago and are still together today. And those birds are producing a lot of our eggs that are going into the wild.
In the next video, you'll learn how fertile eggs are produced at the International Crane Foundation.